We were taken deep below Gaza's central prison to a special ward where men suspected of collaborating with Israel are held. Al Jazeera was given exclusive access to the block of cells, which is under strict security protocol. Abu Mustafa is responsible for the inmates. He tells me they are kept isolated for their own safety, because if others knew of their alleged crimes, they could be killed.
There are 8 prisoners here. We only let them out to use the bathroom and to pray. But whenever we let them leave the cells, we cover their faces with a hood.
The inmates were instructed not to speak to us, but we were told by prison officials they all deny the charges against them.
Suspected collaborators can spend days, weeks, and even years in these 1x2 meter cells before they face a revolutionary court who will decide their fate.
On Friday, Hamas executed 18 suspected Israeli informants. 7 were killed publicly on this street corner in Gaza City. It was the largest number of suspected collaborators killed by Hamas in a single day since it took control of the Gaza Strip in 2007. The executions followed an Israeli airstrike on a house that killed 3 of its most senior military commanders. It was the single biggest strike against Hamas's armed wing since fighting began more than 6 weeks ago, and its leaders have made it clear that anyone suspected of working with Israel would also be punished. The family of one of the men executed on Friday buried him without the usual Islamic funeral rites. His relatives, worried about being recognized, wanted our camera crew to leave, but insist he was wrongly accused.
My brother is innocent. Our lawyers say all the charges against him were false. This is all a propaganda.
Israel has a long and successful history of recruiting collaborators and informers in the occupied West Bank and in the Gaza Strip. They do so through a variety of different means, sometimes with money, other times it's through blackmail, or by intimidating family members. Whatever the case, the mere suspicion of having ties to Israeli forces is enough to end up here. Imtiaz Taib, Al Jazeera, at the Gaza Central Prison.